What is materials and engineering? Every day we deal with materials in our daily life. Every materials involve materials engineering. The history of Stone Age, Bronze Age, Iron Age, and Silicon remind us the importance of materials. These developments have allowed us to do things that we could not do before. More durable farming tools, for instance, it is a result due to the development of iron. Iron also let us have more effective weapons. It has allowed civilizations to advance. In this section, you will learn the basic idea of structure, property, processing, relationships. This is important topic to learn because everything in material science is related to how structure, properties, and processing interact with each other. You should be able to understand the relationship of at least the three elements, which is structure, properties, and processing. You will also learn how materials are classified and how the materials differ from each other in terms of properties and applications. There are many different names in order to classify materials. Self-assembled materials, biomimetic materials, biomaterials, and nanomaterials, and etc. Self-assembled materials is a material that can occur spontaneously in nature. Biomimetic materials are materials that develop using inspiration from nature. It may also be useful in the design of composite materials. Biomaterials are materials that has been engineered to interact with biological system for medical purpose. And nanomaterials are materials that have structure at the nanoscale. These nanomaterials often have unique optical, electronic, or mechanical properties. Many other different ways to classify materials. Whatever how many other different ways it is classified, fundamentally it can be classified based on its structure. Structure, what we mean here is the type of bonding. If it is classified based on structure, it can be categorized into three major types of materials. It is metals, ceramics, and polymers. Polymers here include rubber and plastics. Another way to classify materials is based on its function. Functions here means we are referring to material unique properties or how the materials are used. For instance, materials that are used in an engineered structure for the purpose of providing mechanical strength or stiffness are called structural materials. Materials used in the body are called biomaterials. Materials used for specifically for electronic properties are called electronic materials. And for material that is used for their magnetic properties, it can be classified as magnetic materials. I believe you may think many other possible functional categories other than what I have described just now. For instance, jet engines, it can be classified as high material, high temperature materials. There are more and more. This is a most important material classification based on its functions. One material can also have many different applications. For instance, stainless steel, it can be used as biomaterial screws for bone repair. For other different applications, stainless steel can also be used as structural material for pressure vessels. This is the important things is we must be able to select material from different applications based on its particular advantages and disadvantages.